Jesus, I'm lost. Someone help me, I'm lost.
Jerry?
Jerry, help me!
Ben, you're just in time. We're being pulled up.
Where's Jerry?
He found Jerry. Jerry's dead. He bought it an hour ago.
Yes, on the face of it, the Barrington case is a perfect example of an appearance after death. But we had to drop it.
Why?
As perhaps you will find out, Clifford Barrington is an odd character. He described his experience in his autobiography, and that's how we got wind of it. But soon after the book was published, he had it withdrawn.
It's unusual.
Very. We don't even have a copy here. When we made the usual request to investigate the case, he was perfectly agreeable at first. Later, he marched in here very angry.
Well, he was agreeable enough when he replied to my letter. He invited us down to his house.
Perhaps he has a soft spot for Americans. All I know is that he stormed in here, and for a barrister, he used very strong language, I recall.
What was he supposed to have seen?
The phantom of a man who just died. He thought he was real and spoke to him. His wife sat up beside him, heard him talking, but the apparition had...
a bad dream. When did he claim it took place?
August the 8th, 1975.
Thanks for your help. I'd like to get a background to a case before I meet the people involved.
Oh, it's been a pleasure. And I'm sure your book on the English paranormal will be a great success.
Thank you.
You have more than enough other material to follow up. If I were you, I'd give Barrington a miss.
Oh, well, it's too late now. He's expecting us this afternoon. I can see you don't take my subject very seriously.
I don't have to, do I? I'm just hired to get you good photographs. Okay?
Okay. Don't worry, I don't expect anyone to share my weird beliefs.
I suppose it's very profitable writing books on the supernatural. But isn't it a bit sick, giving people false hopes, helping them think they'll see their dear departed again?
My books are not about spiritualism, they're about paranormal phenomena.
Oh, excuse me.
And I began writing them because I wanted to try and understand something that happened to me once.
Don't tell me you saw a ghost.
Yes.
You actually saw a ghost?
I owe my life to him.
That woman was staring so hard.
No, it looks fine to me. In fact, it looks pretty good.
You were saying?
Yeah, it's usually a psychic person that triggers off paranormal activity, even without knowing it.
Are you psychic?
No.
But you said you saw a ghost.
Yeah, that was different. Somehow, my friend made an effort to come back out of concern for me.
I'm sorry, go on.
No, I'm interested in the Barrington case because it's similar to mine. Someone reappearing within an hour of death. Why did you do that? The road was clear.
I must be seeing things. I could have sworn there was a woman on the road.
Must have been a shadow from a tree. Never mind.
Why did you withdraw your book?
My wife persuaded me. I was still a practicing barrister then. She thought it'd be bad for my career if it got round that I believed in the supernatural.
But you don't mind talking to me about your experience?
Oh, well, that's different. I'm retired now. I've enjoyed your books. I feel I can trust you. But I think you'll find there's nothing worth writing up.
Well, I'd like to be the judge of that.
Give that a wide berth when you're going past it. It's ready to collapse. Can't afford to repair it. Everything's so damned expensive these days. So I'd better go back and get ready for dinner. Eat early here. Country ways, you know. Country ways.
Sit there, won't you?
Thank you. Will you sit there?
Do stay a couple of days with us. There's a lot I'd like to discuss.
Well, I hope we can. I think there's a lot you could tell me.
But did you really see a phantom?
I thought so at the time. I'd led the prosecution at the trial of Davidson, the child molester.
Clifford, we don't want to hear all this.
Be brief. Davidson had got a pretty stiff sentence. He shouted he couldn't live in prison. Scared of what the others might do to him, I suppose.
Clifford.
Sorry.
Do please finish your story.
Well, that night, I woke up to see the blighter in my room in prison clothes. My first thought was that he'd escaped and he was after me. He gave me a look of pure hatred. And then he was gone.
You mean he faded away? Surely it must have been a nightmare.
He didn't fade. He just wasn't there any longer. The next morning, I phoned the prison authorities. Davidson had hanged himself in his cell a few minutes before my experience.
There's a draft.
Oh, Rose, there may be a window open.
Oh, no, I'm sure there's not.
Well, turn on the lights and make sure.
Young girls having the vapors had gone out of fashion.
She said she had a dizzy spell. Good night.
Good night. I think I'll turn in too. I'm still pretty jet-lagged. Who is that?
Oh, that's my late wife.
Thank you.
Please help me. I think I'm going mad. That woman, the one in the road, and all the Portuguese agent was in my bed. Bye.
Nothing's going to hurt you. Here, take your time. Sit down. Oh. Tell me what happened.
You'll feel better.
I've never believed that. Oh, David. So what is it? I mean, reverberations from the past or what?
Well, I could say you'd seen a ghost, but that's too simple.
I know I definitely saw something there, but I still logically can't believe in ghosts.
Well, whatever it is, it's more complex than the usual manifestation. Something here isn't right. I want to find out what it is. Now, on the face of it, Barrington has been quite open.
I know, it's that wife who gives me the creeps. Sometimes she has a sort of mad look.
I wonder what it is that made him withdraw his autobiography. What would make anyone do that? I think if we could get hold of a copy, we might find out.
But they haven't even got one at the Society for Psychical Research.
Is it true that there's a copy of any book in print at the British Museum?
Yes, I think so.
Well, that's worth a try. I'll take a trip to London tomorrow. Will you be all right?
Sure. Perhaps you could drop me off into the country somewhere and I'll shoot a few rolls of film. There is one thing. I don't really want to go back to my room tonight. This isn't fun.
Stay away from the Grange until dark. I'll be back by then.
Yes, sir. Have a nice day. Oh, and remember, drive on the wrong side of the road.
I expect this book I ordered.
The shelf number tells me that this book is one of many stored in our Woolwich depository. Such books are brought here by the van. Today's van is running late. Perhaps in an hour or two. Have no worry, sir. We do not close until 9 tonight.
Oh, there you are. Starting to worry.
Oh, well, I wandered farther than I meant to.
Well, come on in. Drinky time. Oh, by the way, David phoned from London. Been delayed. He won't be back till midnight. So we have you to ourselves.
Great.
Mr. Jordan? The book's arrived.
Great. Thank you.
Foot of my bed stood the man who had been sentenced that afternoon as a result of my efforts. At that moment, I had no doubt of the nature of his visit. Summoning up my self-control, I began to reason with him. The sound of my desperate voice woke my wife, who lay beside me. She sat up in the bed, asking what was the matter. But by then, the intruder was no longer there.
Sam.
I went to sleep and woke up to find someone trying to suffocate me.
What?
I'm not hurt. It was like a nightmare, only I was wide awake. It was another of these,
manifestations.
So, how did you get on in London?
Oh, it was a waste of time. It took them 5 hours to bring me the book.
But you read about the haunting.
Yes, but I didn't find out anything we didn't know already.
Did it give you the date of the happening?
The same as the librarian at the Society told us, 1975, August. Why?
Was Mrs. Barrington mentioned?
Only that she sat up in bed beside him, asking what was happening.
I thought so. David, that would have been totally impossible. At that time, Mrs. Barrington had been paralyzed for well over a year.
So who was with him?
Isn't Mrs. Barrington.
Elizabeth.
She must have moved in as Barrington's mistress when Vera Barrington became totally immobilized. Poor lady. She must have been in hell seeing another woman take her place and unable to lift a finger. She must have really hated her.
A hatred that has kept her spirit in the house.
You mean it's the cause of these manifestations?
Yes, and it's been waiting for somebody psychic to come along and reactivate it.
But you said you're not psychic.
I'm not. You are.
Oh. Now I see. Just now, for a moment, on the bed, I was the Vera Barrington of 10 years ago. But who was trying to suffocate me?
Elizabeth Barrington.
Of course. When she read Barrington's book and saw that he used the word wife to describe her, a man in his position with a paralyzed wife would hardly admit that the woman in his bed was his mistress.
So she made him withdraw the book in case people realized the situation from the dates. I have to get you out of here.
Do you think Barrington?
About the murder?
Yes.
I doubt it. I think you're the first to know that little secret. No logic. You're the cause of all this. Let's get out of here.
Thank you. another tale of mystery and suspense in that series called Worlds Beyond, next Thursday evening at the same time.